Hi everybody, I'm Derek Gilman, and today I'm going to show you how to use a jeweler's loupe to assess the quality of your cannabis flowers. Jeweler's loupes come in many different types. They come in different magnifications. They come with or without a light. They come in different finishes, silver, gold. They come with or without a case. But what's most important are those initial two criteria that I mentioned, the magnification and whether or not it has a light. The 40x loupe that I have today is about the minimum level of magnification that I would suggest for use in assessing cannabis flower. The light is very critical and it's very handy to have. You're not always going to be in a situation where you can take your nug outside to get a really proper look at it, so it's very handy to have a loupe with a built-in light. So the first thing we're going to assess today is the handling of this nug. The handling is a very critical part of the process. Effectively, the trichomes that contain all the flavor, all the magical goodness, all the medicinal qualities of the cannabis flower, those trichomes and those trichome heads especially are very fragile. Once the flower has been dried, those little trichome heads just naturally want to start breaking off. And so by using a loupe, we can have a close look at our cannabis flower and see how well it's been handled by looking at how many of those heads are intact. Yeah, and immediately I can tell that this flower has been handled very nicely, because I'm not just seeing a whole bunch of trichome stalks, I'm seeing trichome stalks with the heads still attached, which is what we want to see. We can also tell how it was trimmed. A nug that's been machine trimmed, first off, all those trichome heads are going to be shaved off and knocked off. All you're going to see is just a bunch of just trichome stalks. And we could also look at the shape of the nug itself. We can see that this one actually still has some contours to it. It's got a couple little leaves still coming off the top here. That lets us know that it hasn't been shaved by a machine, which is always a good sign. Anytime a machine has been used to trim a nug, it just inevitably beats it up, knocks off a lot of those trichome heads, and that's just that's what you're paying for. It's the medicine that you want intact. What we can also do with this loupe is we can assess the ripeness of those trichomes and ultimately the ripeness of this flower. So what we look for when we're looking at those trichome heads under magnification is we look for their coloring. Because trichomes, they go through stages of maturation. And before the trichomes have fully matured, those heads, they're clear. Okay? And then they move as the flower matures, as the flower ripens, as those trichomes mature and ripen, those clear trichome heads transition to a milkiness. And once they get most ripe, once they hit their peak ripeness, those trichome heads begin to turn amber. So when we're looking at this flower, we want to see a truly ripe flower. The majority of those trichome heads will not only be intact, but they're also going to be in various shades of amber. Okay, so if you find too many of these heads that are clear and sparkly, it's going to let you know that the flower likely wasn't as mature and ripe as it could have been. Something else we can look for in the quality of this flower is we're going to look for any contamination. Contamination could be anything from dirt, debris, or even insect feces. Yes, specifically caterpillars. Caterpillars love to chew on cannabis, and as they do, they're leaving feces in their wake. Cat hair, dog hair, even nastier stuff such as powdery mildew or mold. Mold is gonna look like small, fine white hairs, distinctly different than the trichomes and the trichome heads. And if you've never done it before, it's just a whole lot of fun to have a look at your flowers and nugs through high magnification. I highly recommend it. You know, once you have this loupe and you're able to kind of crawl into that nug on a microscopic level, and you get into that forest of trichomes, it's a wondrous, magical little place. I suggest you try it out sometime. I'm Derek Gilman, until next time.